The home.
It's great to be in Lisburn City with 130 of the best pipe bands in Europe. Over 3,000 pipers, drummers and drum majors are here to thrill us on the wonderful art of pipe band music, and all competing for the title of European Champions 2004. We have a feast of piping, drumming and mace flourishing, and you'll be meeting some of the great personalities from the world of pipe bands. There's a huge amount at stake for all the bands, and the tension amongst them is running high.
As president of the Northern Ireland branch, I must be honest and say that I'm hoping our local bands do really well and that not much of the silverware goes back to Scotland.
We're starting off with bands right at the top in Grade 1. Senior champion drum major Paula Braden leads in Ballycoan. They're a long-established band from the Portishburn area of Belfast. Under pipe major Alfie Ray, son of their former pipe major Brian Ray. Sam Connolly, Rivara's pipe major, follows in the footsteps of his father, William. They're a dedicated band who so far haven't had the luck they deserve this year, but they have high hopes for today. The next band, Blerian District, were promoted to Grade 1 only last year, and at the rate they're going, they could present a surprisingly real threat to the big boys.
The band have been practicing hard all year, and it's my intention to play on Saturday for the first time this year. And I think there's a determination in the band to give the performance that will be hopefully unrivaled on the day of the competition. And we will be aiming to win the competition.
The first band of the line has won the European title 3 times in the last 5 years. They've already won the Scottish and All-Ireland Championship this year, and they're determined to bring the Hamilton Anderson Trophy back to Northern Ireland. Field Marshal Montgomery.
Everybody needs to get to striking the tune together, and nothing must go wrong at the beginning. I think that's what's in everybody's mind when they get to that line. It's, I hope that the whole thing starts off properly, because usually if you start off properly, then that sets the scene for the rest of the competition piece.
All Grade 1 bands have to prepare 2 different sets to play, and at the line they draw out a numbered token to dictate which of the 2 will be played.
There are a number of rivals at the top end of Grade 1, and you only just have to look at the results over the past couple of years. It's almost always the same bands in the top 6. This year in particular, I think the band were first in the Scottish Championships, and Shots and Dykehead were second, and the result was reversed in the British Championships. So there are a number of bands out there, but obviously on the terms of what's happened this year, you would consider them obviously to be a big threat on the day. I think St Lawrence O'Toole over the last few years have been climbing up the leaderboard in Grade 1, and they've certainly been a threat this year.
Thank you.
we had the unfortunate position of me not being able to play at the beginning of this season, and we had the opportunity to bring in somebody to take over my position, and he's done a tremendous job. He's a young guy called Alistair Dunn, and he's done a great job this year with the band, and I think that shows people out there that even a few years down the road when I retire, then there's still somebody to take over the band and keep it at the standard that it's currently at.
Over the past few months as paid major of the band, it's been a tremendous experience for me. It's something that I wasn't expecting, maybe unfortunate circumstances, but having Richard back today in the band was excellent. I think everybody feels really confident when they know that he's in charge of the band. He's won 3 world championships. It's just fabulous. I had a great experience being in charge of the band, and maybe in the near future I'll concentrate my talents and try and improve those so that when the time comes, if I take over the band, then I'm going to be the man for the job.
The future of piping looks very, very bright, especially in this part of the world, but I think when you see today's competition, when you see the amount of young people taking part in all the bands, right through all the grades, it shows that there will be a tremendous future for piping and drumming, and not only in this part of the world, but throughout the British Isles, certainly.
You worry about how you start and how it's going to go. Hopefully you don't make any mistakes. That's when the nerves start to kick in, when I get up to the line.
Next we have a Scottish band who have won 7 European titles in the last decade and are the current world champions. They're recognised as one of the premier grade one bands. Today they're determined to beat Field Marshal Montgomery and become European champions once again. The House of Edgar shuts in Dykehead.
A band comes to start their performance, we're looking for what might be described as the 4 ints: introduction, intonation, integration, and now interpretation. Introduction has to be nicely pitched on an E on the chanters and well blown with a nice piping sound. Intonation follows that, and the band must have a comfortable, easy to listen to sound. Integration, well, that in itself is explanatory. And when we come to interpretation, we look at pacing of the performance, the melody, the rhythm. Those aspects are all important in a performance.
Well, there's a great rivalry between the bands all the time, and as I go around the different band halls watching them practice, they put an enormous amount of effort into it, and after the practice you could wring the perspiration out of their shirts, and they do this in order to win.
Feeling very confident. The weather is looking good, so we're a sunny weather pipe band, as we call ourselves, and we're feeling confident. All we need is a good performance.
Next is a band from the Republic of Ireland that is really on the up. Though they lost to Field Marshal at the All-Ireland, they beat them in MSR. Today's championship is solely MSR, so they have a real chance to steal the Premier Trophy from the big boys, St. Lawrence O'Toole.
Playing here today would be very eligible for a prize in the top six, but I suppose our main rivals would be Field Marshal Montgomery and Shots and Dykehead.
Thank you.
Well, I'd eventually hope to follow in my father's footsteps. I've been involved in it since the day I was born. I've been going to competitions from ever since the day I was born. It's just been around for so long. Oh, my dad has been a huge influence. He's taught me everything I know. My granny and my grandfather both played pipes. My grandmother played in the City of Dublin Pipe Band and the Emerald Girls Pipe Band. My grandfather actually taught the Emerald Girls Pipe Band, and that's how they met up. And my dad, he's a piper, obviously, and my two uncles used to play pipes, but they've now given it up. And my auntie was a drummer, so basically it's been in my family the whole way.
Now we can see just how the big boys have fared against one another today.
Grade 1 European Champions 2004. In first place, Field Marshal McDonald. In second place, St. Lawrence O'Toole from Ireland.
Joining them in third place are Shots and Dykehead. Fourth, Strathclyde Police. Clan Gregor Society 5th and Scottish Power 6th.
I was 8 years old and I'd started competing, and Mum and Dad were there every week, and they purchased a camper, which is great for a drum major.
Started as a drum major by going along to competitions and watching the other drum majors. I was really inspired by Alan McBride and his sister Violet and brother Harry, who were the elite drum majors back then.
Daddy's the bus driver and Mummy's the wardrobe lady, so it's great to have their support.
I practice about an hour every day, 5 days a week, and then all day Saturday for the competition, so it does take a little bit of time.
A couple of years ago at Portrush on the Friday night, me and my friend Brian Molson were out having a practice, and the first throw, I threw it up and it came down the wrong way and it kind of sliced across my eyebrow.
Nasty accidents in the past have been a broken nose, several stitches in my face.
I actually won that day, so it actually gave me a bit of luck, so it wasn't too bad.
It's both an adrenaline rush, great fun. I have great fun competing as a drum major. And it's just a hobby for me, so I really enjoy doing it.
Just as soon as they shout and the band starts, that's whenever everything just flows. I don't have to think about it. I've practiced it all morning and it just automatically comes out.
I've been very fortunate to travel throughout the world, New Zealand, Australia, South Africa, America, with being a drum major. So there is a very wide family of pipe bands and drum majors throughout the world, and I've been very fortunate to be able to travel and see and have friends all over the world.
Well, obviously with the European Championships, there's a lot of people that come from Scotland and from down south, and the competition in that is just unbelievable. It's great to be standing in amongst all these gentlemen, you know, big men compared to me, and it's a great feeling just to be standing there even when I make the final. Like 5 out of maybe 30 competing, and it's an absolutely great feeling.
Grade 2 now, and Edinburgh's Drambuie Kirkliston are a real Scottish threat to the Northern Ireland bands today, and Ballinderry will certainly be watching them closely. County Fermanagh's Killadees are a band to be watched in the future. They have been recently upgraded, and pipe major Brenton Murphy has worked wonders with the band since joining them 2 years ago. The Killeen Band hails from County Armagh. Its pipe major Philip Boyce has been working very hard with the band, and on present form they are due some trophies soon. Cully Becky will certainly be keeping an eye on them.
Yeah, well, I feel pretty good on the day of a contest when I'm taking the band up to the line, and as you know, we bring them to ease and then bring them to attention when the judges is ready. There is a wee bit of nerves comes through just when I'm given the command of by the right quick march, up until the band has actually went through their introduction. I think if the band has a good introduction, then the nerves tend to go away and you just settle into your performance and hopefully enjoy it.
It was as a player in our next prize-winning band that the legendary broadcaster Tommy Miller began his love affair with piping. This year the band may have been edged out of the top place at the All-Ireland by Ballinderry Bridge, but they're still a real force to be reckoned with. Cully Becky are at the line. Thank you.
Since Noel took the band over, he's done a magnificent job and he's took them right up to the pinnacle of grade two. So they will be our main rivals as they've been all season. I think Noel's a character and he has done a brilliant job. I think the main rivals from Scotland will be Drambuie Kirk Lisson. Thank you. think Mervyn, everybody's their own way of going mad, and this is possibly our way of doing it. But it's just the spectacle of the whole thing and the sounds of the bands. I think it just attracted me from a very young age. And it's just that the friendship you come up with down the years, people you've known for years through the bands, and you see them every Saturday, you probably wouldn't have them friends if you weren't in pipe bands.
As well as being in a worldwide circle of friends, you find that whole families are also dedicated pipers, drummers, or drum majors.
Our band has a very, very strong family tradition. There's one time the band won All Ireland in grade 4 in the 70s, and one woman was everybody's grandmother except for two, and she was their mother. There's actually one wee fella in the band, and he's the fifth generation of his family to play in the band, so it's very close-knit.
This year, promotion to grade 1 is a real possibility for one of our local bands. Their pipe major, Noel Mullen, has instilled in them a real competitive edge and a determination to win. For them, the tension is enormous. A real force to be reckoned with. It's Ballinderry Bridge.
Every Saturday that I put on a uniform, I want to win that competition. Every aspect of that competition, we want to win the drumming, the piping, and the bass section. If you don't want to win, I question your point in the 10. We want to win. Every competition we go to, we have the hunger and the determination and the drive. We're going to try to win today. We're not the only band that has a good chance of winning today from the Northern Ireland branch. Another band that is in with a real shout is Colabacchi. They have a very good drum corps, they always finish well up the leaderboard in the drumming stakes, and their pipe corps has improved leaps and bounds over the past few seasons. They come from a very good pedigree, having been one of the top grade 1 bands a few years ago, so they'll also be hungry for success today. Thank you. This has been the best season so far for the band to date since it started competing way back in the early 70s. The highlight of the year has been winning the All-Ireland Championships at Letterkenny. That is what we set out to do at the beginning of the year, and we had really given it a massive push in order to do that. So the way that we see it is that anything from here on in is an added bonus. Now, if we could win the European Championships today, that would be another step towards the ultimate goal in us reaching grade one.
At this stage, the 37 bands in grade two are tense and waiting.
Grade two European champions. In first place, Ballinderry Bridge, number 18.
Joining Ballinderry on the awards are Drambuie Kirkliston, Tullibackie, Killadees, Royal Scots Dragoon Guards and Uppercross Guard.
We'll be back next week with more pipe band music, the characters and the tensions that lead to either delight or despair. And there's no better way to finish with the mass pipes and drums of the European Championships 2004 as they salute the chieftain.
Yes, more from the European Pipe Band Championships next Monday at the same time, 25 to 11. On the way tonight on BBC One, Stand Up with Jack D.
It's week two for the McGraths in 1904, and it's time to clean their act up.
We'll have to get these socks washed today, boys, because there's a bit of a calm.
Excuse me a minute.
Jo Brand sets her sights on Big Brother and style queens Trini and Susanna when she joins Jack D live at the Apollo in 40 minutes here on BBC One.
Welcome back to the city of Lisburn and the European Championship 2004. It's great to be in Lisburn City with 130 of the best pipe bands in Europe. Over 3,000 pipers, drummers and drum majors are here to thrill us on the wonderful art of pipe band music, and all competing for the title of European Champions 2004. We have a feast of piping, drumming and mace flourishing, and you'll be meeting some of the great personalities from the world of pipe bands. There's a huge amount at stake for all the bands, and the tension amongst them is running high.
It's a tremendous feeling to have brought a major championship to what is my home city. When I was born and bred here many years ago, it was a small town that then became a borough and now a city. It's great, a great, great feeling to be here as president with such a major championship.
We have a very cross-section of spectators. They can be people who are an avid interest in piping, or it can be the average man in the street who is coming along with his family to find out what's going on, and we want everyone to enjoy the experience.
The first grade on show is the starter grade 4B, where most of today's top bands began their competitive careers. It won't be long before we see Thiepval Memorial from Donegal in the prizes, under the excellent Alison McKnight, one of only four female pipe majors in Ireland. Tyrone's Gorda Clare and Grade 4A are a band for the future. Under pipe major Norman Cochran, they are a real challenge to Onsborough at the top of this grade. Banbridge are good, consistent performers in 3A. Led by their pipe major Alan Gurley, They are joined by their starter band for the March Past. These up-and-coming players may later feed into the senior band. Auchnavay Memorial from Newry County Down are working their way up Grade 3B with Pipe Major Colin Moffat. This year they have already won the British Championships and are a force to be reckoned with today.
Pipe bands is a thing that's probably in your blood from a lot of years. You just don't sort of develop it overnight. It has to be in your system for a long, long time. And I know what motivates me is wanting to win. And I think that the rest of the band would be in a similar mode, that you go out on a Saturday and what you're wanting is to be called out number one.
On present form, our next band is definitely on the way up. They've had major success at both the Scottish and All-Ireland Championships. Certainly promotion to Grade 2 is within their reach. And should they continue to excel, even Grade 1 is a possibility. Really going for it. Seven Tires.
Probably our main rivals will be, from the home front, will be Maracou, who have been very hot at their heels and all season so far on the home front. But this is their first major championship this year, and well, there are a few dark horses in Scotland that we'll have to keep our eye on. Has been talked about already this year, but don't think that Grade 2 is on the cards at the minute. I think Grade 3B, as you know yourself, was used as a sort of a stepping stone to get actual Grade 3, and I look at it that way. I want to prepare the band, and well, if they're going to get into Grade 3 next year, fair enough, but I want to prepare the band for Grade 3, and I think any higher than that would be too quick. Too soon. I relish the task in 3A. Well, hopefully, if we can get as good a run as what we can play in the band hall, and what we've been having, certainly will not be far away. It's just getting everybody focused and getting them mindset on the job and getting the whole thing relaxed and going on, having a good clean run. One slip and that's you out of it.
Back in the contest circuit since 2003, having had a period to regroup, our next band has returned with a renewed hunger. They are thought to be the new contenders for the top of this grade, and on their present form could certainly upset the 3B results today. Ready to go, Marlacou.
Everyone that goes to line in our grade is a rival and they're all going to win, but seven tars would be the main opposition over this side of the water. They've been successful this year. Davy Reid has been doing a good job with them and his band's been getting good results.
The band broke up in 1991 and 1992, and it was in the September of the year 2000 that I took the band over again and went into contest season last year in 4A, and we've been promoted to 3B this year, and to date we've been successful enough in 3B. It's nice to be back.
Now, the outcome that everyone in grade 3B is waiting to hear.
Grade 3B European champions, first place, 7 towers, number 30.
In second place is Marlacou, followed by Fenton Lawler, St. Patrick's Bandon, Air Pipe Band Society and Arbroath RBLS.
Every year, from the year before, the performances have got better. And this is particularly noticeable in the lower grades. For example, grade 3 bands would have probably won the World Championships grade 1 20, 25 years ago.
It's great to have a band that can come and play in the like of this, whether you win or not. As they're going to the line, nerves are going to play a big part. If they can get over their nerves, settle down, get a good start, I think we'll do well.
Our next band is over 100 years old. 1999 was their best ever season as a competition band. They were promoted in 2000 to Grade 4A. This season has been even better for them. Already runners-up at a European Championship and having taken every trophy at the All-Ireland Championship, at the line, it's Amsborough.
Championship like this comes along, there's no last minute alterations to make. Practice 2 nights a week, as much practice at home as possible. You don't do that, you needn't come here today. Very good season. We've had a couple of seconds and I think 3/4, and especially the All-Ireland, 4/4 in the All-Ireland.
The 24 bands in Grade 4A are all waiting for the announcement.
Grade 4A European Champions 2004. In first place, Ansborough, number 2.
Second to Ansborough are Linlithgow and District, followed by Stow, Queen Elizabeth, Gorda Clare, and Corpus Christi.
I think if you look at the majority of bands out in the field today, you'll find that the average age is certainly a lot younger than us here I would say the average age in a band now is in the low 20s. We have kids' bands starting at age 10, 11 and 12, and they're competing at a very high standard. And if they're the future of the organisation, I think it's in a very healthy state.
We're very ambitious. I find that a big problem, being pipe major. The fillment of players and winning prizes on a Saturday, it's kind of hard to draw the line at it. You don't like to think almost you're weaker players, but it's all, you don't really want to be dropping players either, which we find it's just a wee bit of a problem for them.
Next to the line is a young band making steady progress in Grade 4B. Inspired to greater things by their senior band in Grade 2, they won the All-Ireland in Letterkenny this year. They're a family band with some members almost the same size as their instruments. Trying to repeat their success at the All-Ireland is Cully Baggy.
We made the decision to start the 4B band to get players into the senior band. We had a junior band before in the early 1980s, which I was part of, and the people that are now running Cully Baggy today are, we were all came through the junior band. And it's good to get your own players and bring them on, teach them the way you want them taught them. Very pleased with the performance today. I gave them all a thumbs up when they come off. Good sound, good blowing, very little mistakes. I was happy with it.
The teamwork on a good day is something that's great.
And there's a good spirit as well, a good team spirit. They work well when it goes well. Sometimes things don't just always fall into place, but we have to make the best of it.
Our next band won the Scottish Championships this year, but were just beaten by Colley Bakkey at the All-Ireland. This youthful, dedicated and determined group of players want to go back to Donegal with the European Championships trophy. Letterkenny and District.
Try to run the band practice like a youth club for young people. They come in, they don't play chanters or pipes or drums all night. They come in and they play maybe badminton or football, and then they come and do a bit of practice. And that seems to encourage them and keep them coming. Well, in a few years' time, I'd like to see the band moving up through the grades. My time will soon be maybe run out anyways. I'd like to pass it on to somebody that can take it on.
This is the moment all the bands in Grade 4B have been waiting for. Kirkcudbright and District come out on top, followed by McNeilstown, Antrim, Lanark and District, Letterkenny and District, and Colley Bakkey.
Well, I think, personally, the best thing you can do is get a good, solid intro from the pipes and the drums, and if you can really get that there, it makes the hair stand on the back of your neck. It makes a judge sit up and listen to you. And, you know, after that there, even you do have maybe a couple of wee fine, silly things, I think, you know, they'll overlook that there. If you can hit them with a good intro and fairly good sound, good playing, and a nice clean finish, you'll go a long way.
The band about to approach the line was promoted to Grade 3A in 2003, It's a family band which is steadily moving up the prize lists. They show all signs of becoming future champions and are determined to regain their 1965 position in Grade 1. The atmosphere here is tense as Quinn Memorial enter the ring.
Well, Finvoy, obviously they're the local rivals. You always like to beat the local rivals. They've a year ahead of us in the grade, but at the end of the day, they have won, I think, about four or five competitions this year. We have pipped them at Banbridge, and I think, you know, if we can really go out there and do the stuff, there's no reason why we can't beat them. At the end of the day, it's not about a good pipe core or about a good drum core. It's about the whole band playing together. And I think we have just as good a band out there as anybody. So certainly there'll be strong opposition, but we'll be just raring to go to get them. Right? Sometimes, if the band goes well, I generally just walk away and never bother listening to anything else. I just let the judges worry about it. But maybe if we have been a wee bit shaky, you tend to listen to the opposition and think, well, maybe they're not just as good as they should have been either. So you've always that wee glimmer of hope there at the end of the day that you're still going to take a prize home.
I'm feeling quite confident. The band have put in two hard nights practice this week on Monday and Thursday night from 8 o'clock to 10. And the band is starting to play really, really well, tight together. And we just think the sound is getting better every Saturday.
The way they are performing at the moment suggests our next band should be able to sink Quinn Memorial's hopes of becoming European champions. Winners at both Bangor and the All-Ireland, and with everything to play for, it's Finvoy.
Well, our main rivals probably today would be the Quinn Memorial. I started with the Quinn Memorial in 1979 and played for 2 years and really enjoyed that time. They've just been upgraded from grade 3B to 3A and have done very well this year and have improved every competition. The band played very well today in Lisburn. The good weather conditions helped the band and the morale is really good. With one in the All-Ireland and one in the last four or five competitions, it's gave us a good morale boost.
Who will be the Grade 3A European champions this year?
Grade 3A European champions. In first place, Finn Boyle, number four.
Following Finn Boy are Strathclyde Fire Brigade, Quinn Memorial, Breedy, Black Raven and North Belfast Working Men's Club.
So the European Championships 2004 have come to their end and our thanks go to the City of Lisburn and the Royal Scottish Pipe Band Association. It's been an outstanding competition full of tension and tears, delight and disappointment. But one thing unites all bands today, across all cultures and nationalities, their deep dedication to the world of pipe bands.
In 1984 was the year that my father passed away. He was the pipe major of the band before me. And at the time of his death, there was... A grave diggers strike in the local graveyard, and both myself and my brother Brendan, who now lives in Australia, had to dig my father's grave. So I suppose this piece of music was not just in my head, but it was in my heart at the time, and that's the result of it.